गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन. इन टुडेज क्लास वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस द डिजाइन ऑफ डिस्टिलेशन कॉलम. द डिस्टिलेशन इज बेसिकली द सेपरेशन ऑफ वॉलेटाइल कंपोनेंट बेस्ड ऑन इट्स बॉइलिंग पॉइंट. सो वन ऑफ द मोस्ट वाइडली यूज्ड कॉलम इज फ्रैक्शनेटिंग कॉलम. सो हियर वी आर डिजाइनिंग फ्रैक्शनेटिंग कॉलम विद अ सी प्लेट. We have a different contacting plates which will generally used to contact gas and vapor, so in the distillation. So one of the most widely used method is bubble cap and then sieve plate, plate type of tray which will be used. In this class we are going to discuss the basic steps of material balance in distillation column. So what is the first material balance? This is a distillation column. Basically, we have a feed overhead product, and this is a residue. So, which is called F. F is a feed. XF is a composition of a feed, and D is a distillate. XT is composition of a distillate, and W and corresponding composition is HD. In usually in a distillation column, so there is a part of the stream which will be taken back to the column, so which is called a reflux. Reflux, which is called reflux R. So therefore, we have to do a material balance. So this is not required here for the material balance. F is equal to D plus W. So this is a material balance, and overall component of the column is FXD is DXD plus WXW. We have a two equation. One is a component balance, overall heat balance, overall material balance. Based on this, we can calculate so D and W. So this is a method of calculation of D and W. Use these equation and calculate D and W. What is important for the distillation column? The vapor liquid equilibria, so that is PLE data, is very very important to calculate the composition of X and Y. So what is X? X is volatile component present in liquid phase, and volatile component present in vapor phase. Means volatile component means we are referring to the more volatile component. So usually we have a binary mixture is X plus Y should be 1. What is the composition of Y? What is the composition of X? So that need to be calculated. So therefore, if you want to calculate Y, Y is equal to 1 minus X. Again, this composition will be depends upon volatility. So volatility of a component A and volatility of a component B. So therefore, we need to know volatility of A, volatility of B. Suppose the boiling point of the A is 65 and boiling point of B is 78, then this is volatile. Then B. This is volatile than B. So B means it is more volatile component. It is less volatile. So that's it. This is a difference between what is more volatile. And suppose if you are having X and Y, you want to separate the component X and Y by the distillation. So whether the distillation is possible or not, that will be decided by volatility ratio of A and B. So that is given by relative volatility of A. Means it is a ratio of volatility of A divided by volatility of B. It is nothing but what is volatility? It is a partial pressure to the mole fraction
divided by partial pressure of B to the mole fraction of B. So this is a method of calculation of alpha. So if alpha AB is equal to 1, no separation. Separation is not possible by the distillation. If alpha AB is greater than 1, then separation is possible. So therefore you try to keep the volatility will be at a higher range. Usually in the separation, it should be nearly more than 1.8, above 1.8. It is usually 2.54. In your calculation, if you see 2.45. So this is a ratio of volatility which will come across to solving the problem. Otherwise, the efficiency of your column will not be there. So if the boiling point difference between two components is high, the distillation will give a better separation. Otherwise, it requires a other technique. We are not going to discuss that one. Okay.
We want to separate A and B by distillation. How this can be solved? Read the problem statement. Write down the composition of A, composition of B, and then what is the feed of A, feed of B, or whatever the B component present in feed, everything should be note down. And from the material balance, F is equal to D plus W. Fxf is equal to dxd plus wxw. From this calculate d and w. From this calculate d and w. To solve, to design of distillation is by McCabe three method. We are going to, so this is a basic material balance. Once if we get a D plus W, then for a chemical engineer you should know how I am going to separate by using a continuous distillation column with McCabe three method. McCabe-Thiele method is a method where you are going to calculate how many number of theoretical plates required. So what you are going to calculate? Number of plates required for the separation. Separation of A and B, separation of A plus B. A may be on the top product, B may be on the bottom. Means it is more volatile, it is less volatile. Automatically it is coming down, and this is automatically it is moving up. So therefore, what is required here? We want composition of more volatile component in a gas and liquid phase. Means you have XY data. Therefore, what is required for you? So you have to get XY data. So if you don't know, you calculate alpha AB. From that you calculate Y by assuming X, assume X, suppose 0, 0.1, 0.2, up to 1, you calculate Y. So it is alpha AB into XA. So this equation, you know, what is this equation, check and then calculate Y. You construct this, so you can assume from 0.1 to 1, so that you will get a XY data.
So in this design calculation, XY data is available in Perry handbook or is available in problem statement. Please make a note of it. So no need to, so both are not the case, then we can go for this. Usually in a design problem we have a XY data from a Perry handbook and or it will be given in a problem statement.
To calculate number of theoretical plates, what is required to calculate number of theoretical plates is very important in a distillation problem. Based on this you are designing a distillation column. What is required here is, number one, XY data. This is called what? Equilibrium, VLE data. So this will be the data referred to the problem statement. You should refer to the problem statement or from Perry handbook or use X and X Y alpha relation. So this is generally not required here. So usually this will be given in a problem statement or in Perry handbook. So therefore we are referring these two. So therefore I am taking a XY data from problem statement or I from a Perry handbook. What is the first step? First step is plot VLE data, XY data. It is called a XY data. XY data. So that will be usually, this is the graph. So please all of you, okay, use the graph sheet. It is very easy to, from the data you plot X and Y. So therefore always take one unit is 0.1, 0.2, like that. Okay, center is 0.5, here it is 1. So here also you use a unit 0.1 only. What is XY data? Locate your point. Your point will be like this. These are the points. So before drawing this point, what is the first point? Draw the diagonal line. So that is called a 45 degree line. So draw the 45 degree line which should join this. Once again, first I am drawing the diagonal and these are the points of X and Y. Join these lines. I am joining these lines, you will get XY plot. So this is called a XY plot. What is number two? Number two is locate XF XD and XW on X-axis. So therefore I am going to locate
xf here. If it is xf is 0.5, this is xf. xd is on the topmost position, so assume this as 0.9. xd will be usually smaller, so this is xd. You can easily see this is xd, this is xf, this is xw, and then this is xd. You can see this one. xd is highest composition, 0.9, xf is feed, and whatever the non-volatile component will come down, so that is xw. Or it will be very less fraction of a volatile component in the bottom. After that, what you should do, you should extend these lines, draw the straight line to cut 45 degree line. It should cut 45 degree line. Extend this to cut 45 degree line. I am extending and cutting here. So this is the point of xd, this is a point of xf, xw. What is this? This is a feed line. This is called a feed line. So it is entering point. Entering point of feed. So therefore, we need to draw the Q line. So Q line is slope of a line from xf on the 45 degree line. Suppose if you see the Q line, please all of you refer your distillation notes in a mass transfer, you will understand. Suppose if it is xf, see here, so this is xf, you can see here, this is xf, this is a point in your graph, here the same point I am showing. So what are the conditions? So this is number 1 and this is number 2, this is number 3, this is number 5, this is number 6. So therefore, feed is cold at its boiling point, saturated vapor, it is vapor and supersaturated vapor. So usually this is a Q line which you are going to calculate. Usually we will get the case of boiling point. If the feed condition is not given in the problem statement, always assume feed enters at its boiling point. Therefore, this is always the straight line. Feed enters at its boiling point if it is not given. If it is given, then you have to use a appropriate equation, calculate the slope. The slope should be calculated from it. You can get this way, this way, this way. This is a probable the slope of Q line. These are the Q line. Here, the Q line is not given, or feed condition is not given. Suppose if I assume feed enters at its boiling point, then your feed line, this line should be straight. So therefore, this is straight. Therefore, this is a Q line. So therefore, I write this one as Q line because feed is entering at its boiling point. Then if you draw any point from here, it is operating line for a enriching section. If you draw anything, then it is an operating line for a stripping section. So therefore, what is operating line for a enriching? Operating line for enriching section. So that is intercept xd divided by r plus 1. You already know xd. You can calculate r, reflex ratio. Substitute, this intercept will be corresponds to y. look at, suppose if your intercept is 0.22, you have to locate 0.22 over here, join this point and this. It is an operating line for enriching section. Just now we have calculated what is the intercept. Intercept is xt divided by r plus 1, r rm plus 1, r minimum. I will explain how to calculate r minimum if it is not given. Generally this rm will be given, substitute and then calculate y. Y is nothing but an intercept. So that value, suppose if you are getting 0.22 or 0.3, so locate here. After location, what you do? Take a scale, join these two points. This is what? This is xd divided by r plus 1, or it is operating line for enriching section. Once you got this point, see here, once you are plotting operating line, it is cutting the Q line, then it is very easy to draw operating line for stripping section. Whatever it is coming down, it is stripped down, or again it will be generated vapor and going back, therefore it is called a stripping section. Once you got this point and this point, simply you can join these two lines. So simply join these two lines. I use some other color, this point and this point. So this is called operating line for, you can extend and then you can write here, this is a operating line for a stripping section. Operating line for stripping section. Once you are plotting operating line for enriching section, operating line for a stripping section, simply you rub this one, nothing should be there here. You can see here. So this is the operating line here and here, and I want only this area, just to remove. I want only this area. See here, you can see this is the area I want. So you can start plotting the straight line, straight, come down, straight here and come down, and it should cut only operating line. Straight, cut the equilibrium curve, come down and it should cut the operating line. Straight, come down, straight, come down, straight, come down. You can calculate now how many number of theoretical plates are required. This is 1, this is 2, this is 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. There are total number of theoretical plates. So therefore, theoretical plates is equal to n minus 1. N minus 1 is because of free bilateral duty. Therefore, you are getting 8 minus 1 is 7. You have a 7 number of plates required for it. So you can check where the feed is entering. Feed is entering at 4th plate. Feed is entering at a 4th plate. So this is a method of calculation of number of theoretical plates required. Please all of you do this using the graph sheet. Take one master's problem and solve. So you can easily learn the McCabe-Thiele method. This is very, very important for the calculation of number of theoretical plates for the design of distribution.